Welcome students to another my online tutorials, and in today's class we are going to discuss about a poem, and the name of the poem is A Tiger in the Zoo, which is written by Leslie Norris. A very nice and at times a humorous and a good poem in which Leslie wants to tell us that the tiger, its original habitat is not zoo but jungle. Okay, so let's begin with the poem. He stalks in his vivid stripes a few steps of his cage on pads of velvet quiet in his quiet rage. So Leslie is talking about the tiger who is in the zoo. He is caged, so he is just walking up and down, or just walking to and fro the length of the cage. And while he is walking, he is very quiet, as is given by the sentence, on pads of velvet quiet. The paw of the tiger is velvety and is very quiet. As he is moving, he is making no noise. The last sentence of the stanza says, in his quiet rage. So quiet rage is an oxymoron, where he is angry. Rage means angry. At the same time, the tiger is quiet. Second stanza, he should be lurking in shadow, sliding through long grass near the water hole where plump deer pass. So just contrasting imagination, just contrasting picture, Leslie is giving us. He's telling if the same tiger would have been in the jungle, what he would have done. So if he would have been in jungle, what he would have been doing? He would have been lurking in shadow. So he would have been waiting for the prey. Lurking in shadow means waiting for the prey. And then when he would have spotted the prey, like a deer coming to the water area, water hole, stream to drink water, what he would be doing? He would quietly, slowly slide through the grass, the vegetation of the forest, near the water hole where the plump deer was. So basically this stanza means that when this deer would have been in, sorry, not deer, the tiger would have been in the jungle, he would have been lurking in the shadow, hiding, waiting for his prey. And when he would have spotted the prey, he would have gone to the water hole, slided through the grass, and would have attacked its prey. Now this deer is called the plump deer. Okay? When plump deer pass. Next stanza, students. He should be snarling around houses at the jungle's edge, baring his white fangs, his claws, terrorizing the village. So what he is telling in the next stanza, like if he would have been a free tiger in the forest, what he would have done? He would have been roaring. He would have been scaring the villagers. Okay? The villagers, those who are there, those villagers, inhabitants, those who are found at the edges of the jungle, you must have come across, if you see the documentary on this Coppet National Park, you will see how these man-eaters, they eat or they terrorize the jungle people. So this tiger would also have come to the edge of the forest or to the edge of the village and would have terrorized the people by showing his white teeth, his fangs. So that is how he would have scared the villagers. But he is locked in a concrete cell, his strength behind bars, stalking the length of his cage, ignoring the visitors. Quite contrary. Just the reverse. What he is doing? He is just locked in the concrete cell, in the prison. And then his strength is what? His strength has been captured behind the bars. And what is he doing? He is just walking the length of his cage and is just ignoring the visitors. Okay? So the last stanza, students. He hears the last voice at night, the patrolling cars, and stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. So when the time of the visitors is over, the zoo is about to be closed. So the patrolling cars are just making sure, or they are ensuring that there is no visitors in the zoo. They are just seeing the last duties of the zoo officials, which they are doing it. So he can hear the patrolling cars, but the tiger just ignores. So what he is doing, lastly, he just stares at the sky, and the brilliant stars are there with his brilliant eyes. He's just staring at the sky. Okay, so that is what is the life of the tiger. So what message or what is the central theme of this poem? The message Leslie Norris wants to give is that the tiger is not supposed to be kept in the zoo. The tiger is supposed to be there in the forest. We are doing cruelty, we are being harsh on the tiger by robbing him of his natural habitat. So once again, just little sum up this poem. So the summary of the poem is that Leslie Norris is just describing the life of a tiger in the zoo who is in the cage. Vice versa, the life of a tiger in the forest. He says, in the zoo, the tiger is caged and he is left with nothing else but just to walk the space which he is having in the cage. There, he is walking quietly. He is in quiet rage. There's oxymoron there. Oxymoron is the device, poetic device, which shows two contradictory feelings. Here it's quiet rage. The second paragraph, second and third stanza, the poet says that what the tiger would have done if it was free in the jungle. If it would have been free in the jungle, the tiger would have been lurking in the shadow, waiting for the prey. And as he would have spotted the prey, he would have slided through the grass and attacked the plump deer. Then he would have gone to the edge of the village or the forest, would have terrorized, scared the villagers by showing his teeth and fangs. But now, in the cage, he's just ignoring the visitors. He's just pacing up and down or the to and fro, the space available to him in the cage. And last stanza, he says that when the time is off, when it is night and the patrolling cars are around, the tiger is just doing nothing but just looking at the brilliant stars with his brilliant eyes. Okay? So this is the poem, A Tiger in the Zoo. And Leslie Norris, once again I repeat, wants to say that the original habitat of the tiger is the forest, not the zoo. Hence, we human beings, we are torturing the animal, we are doing something wrong by keeping the tiger in the zoo, and the tiger should not be kept in the zoo and they should be left in the jungle, the natural habitat of the tiger.